The search for a bruiser on Reimer Davis comes less than a week before they're supposed to compete in a gas balloon race during this year's Balloon Fiesta. As crews set up equipment and tents to host Balloon Fiesta, reaction is pouring in from balloonists who are a close-knit group.
85% of what we worry about never happens. But because they're our friends, because we know them personally, it has a little bit more of an effect on many of us. But again, as a 28-year Army veteran, that's been involved in extreme situations, I've got to deal with what I know.
And because so much can happen during the takeoff, flight, and landing of a balloon, there are many dangers.
It's something balloonists know all about, but the love of the sport outweighs the risks.
This is Richard Abruzzo recovering in the hospital after a September 2005 accident when his gas balloon crashed in Kansas.
It's nothing short of remarkable, I think, that the recovery I've had.
Richard suffered a broken rib, wrist, and pelvis, falling at least 30 feet out of his gondola.
I woke up, laying on the ground on the side of a Kansas, cornfield.
Fast forward 5 years, but tonight we don't know what's happened to Richard Abruzzo.
We do know that there is a large search and rescue effort undergoing right now with a number of aircraft in the air and some what they call fast boats, very fast recovery boats.
Han says because of the length of gas balloon trips,
in today's gas ballooning, a short flight is 1 to 2 days.
A lot can go wrong, especially when you consider the uncertain weather, which may or may not be the cause of Abruzzo's disappearance.
No sense in rushing to any kind of judgment. We don't know really what happened.
It is now after 6:30 in the morning in Italy, so search efforts are once again very active as crews look for Richard Abruzzo and Dr. Carol Reimer.